Yeah, guys, we are back, guys. Shout out to everybody, guys. Shout out to all the subs. Shout out to everybody who clicked on this, guys. I know it's been way too long since, you know, we were supposed to go through all his albums, and then, you know, it's been a while, but we're back, guys. Finally, guys. So, guys, I don't even want to talk too much. I kind of just want to get right into this, guys. Because if you guys know me, if not, I'll never shut up, guys. So, guys, we're here. We're queer, guys. We don't want any more bears. Guys, released August 31st, 2018. We got Bloom with Troye, Sivan. Let's get into it. Guys, that was guys, that was like, man, you know, the whole thing, you know, I'm all over the place. In my mind, I'm all over the place. Like, I don't know where to start. Like, fuck. You guys ever smoke and you try not to cough and then you're fine, but as soon as you take a deep breath and you cough. Oh my gosh, this whole time I've been trying not to cough. Guys, yeah, that was like, you know, the whole thing to me felt very, I don't know how to describe it. Like, I think because the combination of the music, but then the lyrics, right? Like, and almost sort of, not even just the combination, but on some of these songs, the juxtaposition between the sounds that we're hearing and the lyrics. Like, it really, really gave it, because I feel like if this album was, would have had, like, I don't want to say generic lyrics, but you know what I'm saying. Like, those standard, generic, pop, you guys know what I'm talking about. Like, whatever, you know what I mean? Fucking, just, like, ABC, fucking 1, 2, 3 type lyrics, you know what I mean? Then, like, if dude had those type of lyrics with this music, it would have been one thing, but, like, you know what I mean? I think, like, because the lyrics were going, like, really deep, and into, like, I don't know, you know, it was very interesting. I mean, it wasn't just about, you know, typically a lot of, I mean, you know, most songs, like, when it's, like, you know, it's typically singing about, like, emotions or something, which, of course, we're on here, but it felt also more than that, like, also, like, an experiential, but almost, like, where, like, as you're hearing it, it's like you feel it, like it's like you're there experiencing what's going on, even though you're not there, and you don't know what's the fuck, and it could literally not be, it could be about a specific thing, but it's all generalities because you don't know what the fuck's going on, because you're just hearing it in your mind, you know what I mean? Like, you don't know the specifics of the situation of what led to the each specific lyric. Maybe you do, I don't know if you're, Maybe he's talked about it in interviews or some shit if you're hardcore. But you know what? You get what I'm saying in general, right? I hope, right? I hope this is not coming off as rambly nonsense. My point is, like, the lyrics kind of, like, were so, like, the way it was, like, written, it was just, it felt like you're, like, there experiencing everything that this was saying. And then, like, but then, like, not only that, like I said, like, the music really, really, because, like, it very much, do you guys know what I'm saying? It very much didn't, it could have been like a very, very sad thing, is my point. It could have gone in the very, very sad direction, but it did not. And some of this, like even like this last track, you know what I'm saying? Like this stuff, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just felt like very raw, just, you know what I'm saying, guys? Like, and also I thought it was very interesting because it was, I really like how, I don't know, like, how different, I guess, this was, from, you know, his new, I'm assuming maybe then the one we're gonna hear before this is gonna be different too, huh? Who knows, but, because, not 100% different, but I felt like this was kind of a different album, you know? I mean, it is a different album, obviously, but you know what I'm trying to say. Like, you know what I mean? It just, it felt different, I really you know what I also really loved though? I really loved that it was, how long was this album? It was like 40 minutes or something. How long was that? Guys, this was 36:52, so 37 minutes basically. Guys, 37 minutes. I love that. I know a lot of people love long albums, guys. I'm not a fan. I get it, but it's like, I don't know. 40, to me, is like perfect. 45, we could do it. after that, it's like, all right, fucking cut it off already, jeez. There's a lot of albums I love that are long, but I'm saying, you know what I mean? I don't know. Anyway, that's a side note. But so I love that this album was not super, super long, you know? I don't know if, you know, everybody loves that, but I don't care what everybody loves. I'm telling you guys what I love. And I love that. Because then it also, doesn't it make you want to just play it again right away? Instead of like this long thing, it's like, all right, well, I don't have time to hear it again. Or I got to be in the mood. I got to have the... This leaves you wanting more, you know? Like, it needs to be shorter. The albums need to be shorter. Whatever. My bad. Guys, all the classic old school albums on vinyl are that length, guys. It wasn't until the CD era that albums... And then the digital era, obviously. You know, you can make albums as long as you want. But, like, all the classic albums from up to, like, the 80s, unless it was a double album, they were only, like, 40, 45 minutes max. Like, we need to get back to that. Guys, shout out to everybody. Guys, we'll be back with some more, guys. Shout out to everybody, guys. Go check out my real channel with my music in the description, guys. We're done there. Go, go, go. And guys, we'll be back.